Plutonian was mean-spirited, evil, and lacks empathy. If there was any bit of mercy left in his heart, it would be a dark wormhole with no ending. He never talked about himself, and even at the time he was still good, no one dare ask, for who can challenge a god on why the sunshine, the rain falls, or thunderclaps? His childhood has never been up for discussion, and his whereabouts is unknown. But one truth about his childhood was that he was eager to love and to be loved. The Plutonian heard a familiar SOS alert, and still in his unmeasurable rage, he flew to where the SOS alert is coming from. Meanwhile, at the lab, the Paladin were able to capture and destroy some of the absconded Modeus androids. Gigamus, at this time, asked his wife if what Charybdis said about her and the Plutonian was true, but Betty Noor denied the allegation, stating that Charybdis was not in his right senses since his twin brother died. They had destroyed 5 of the Modeus androids, and Qubit told the rest of the group that the absconded Modeus androids' intentions was not to leave the premises, that he believes they were up to something sinister he can't give answers to at the moment. Even with this information, chances can't be taken, for if the Modeus androids find their way out of the lab, it might be catastrophic for the world, for they were crafted to mimic the behavioral intellect of Modeus. Charybdis thinks Qubit creating these androids was an irresponsible choice of idea, a big mistake and a stupid risk, but Qubit still maintained his stance that they are not as dangerous as everyone anticipated, for they were created to locate the whereabouts of Modeus, because at this moment in time, he is the only one that will be able to stop the Plutonian. Before they know what was happening, they were attacked by the last of the Modeus android, but lucky enough, Qubit was able to contact the rest of the group for help, and they came to their rescue and destroyed the Modeus android before it could do more damage. Now Qubit realizes that the last of the Modeus android was in the storage facility going through the late Samsara's personal effects, and in shock discovered that the android had found a panic button that was given to Samsara by the Plutonian and triggered the button to summon the Plutonian to the lab. So everyone understood that the Plutonian was on his way, and this means trouble. So with the head of the Modeus android in his hand, Qubit pressed his quantum jumper to make a portal for them to escape before the Plutonian arrived, in which they passed through, leaving Charybdis behind, who decided to stay to buy time for them from the Plutonian, in which the portal took them to the secret lair of the Plutonian under the guardians of the Modeus android. The furious Plutonian smashed and crashed into the lab, went for a powerless Charybdis, grabbed him by the jugular, but before he could ram and bash his head with his fist, Charybdis played a video from the past which detailed how a virus made out of sound frequency was affecting children by eating their flesh and turning them into zombies, which eventually was attacking people. But the strangest thing about this virus was that they had no idea where it came from or by who. The Paladin came to face the truth that the Plutonian was more psychotic than they thought or anticipated. They realized that he was deranged even before he unleashed his rage, for there was more to him that meets the eye. About 3 years ago to this time, there was this virus floating around, and it was spreading like wildfire, and its major victims were children, in which it liquefies their skin and muscles, then animates their skeletons and turn them into zombies. No cogent reasoning was given why this was happening, just kids turning into zombies and attacking people. The virus was not airborne. It affected them through some very low frequency, for it was an ultrasonic life form which travels through the sound of the living. But what was most shocking to the twins on that day was that the Plutonian almost lost his mind. He went blank and was wiped out of his mind when he saw what was happening, what the virus was doing to the children. He was dumbfounded and just stood there in awe. He later snapped out of it, and with the help of his colleagues, they were able to contain the virus from spreading further. But that day was not a happy, victorious one. It was a day of sadness. A lot of children lost their lives due to this nefarious and mysterious virus. And to make matters more interesting, Charybdis accused the Plutonian of being behind the spread of the virus that killed those children.